Hello, in this video I want to give you a short overview over possibilities in cable structures, theoretical background. The first example you can find in the ASE.dat folder, ASE5.dat, that is just only a little frame and two cables. If we load the frame from the left with 10 kN, we get only a cable tension in this element. The other cable falls out if we make a non-linear analysis. If we reduce the force from 10 to 9 kN, then only this cable is active with only 12 kN cable force. If we have a little load from the right now, we see that the first cable now falls out and the other cable takes the work and has now 1 kN tension. If we run the same analysis with TH3 geometrical nonlinear, including cable sagging, we get the following effect. In the first load case by 10 kN, also the first cable here is working, but you see another little blue tension in the other cable. If we reduce to 9 kN, it's nearly the same effect, but if we have only 1 kN from the right, we see that now really both cables have a normal force. And if we look to the cable sagging, we see here in the first stage the first cable is nearly straight, while the other cable that has no or only a little normal force has a big inner sagging. And if we have the load from the right side, both cables have an inner sagging. The advantage is that no cable falls out here in this or in this analysis. All cables are always under tension. Maybe the tension is small, but a cable never falls out. And this is a big advantage if you make geometric nonlinear analysis. Cable division. Here I have an example where the long cable is not divided, only one element, and the lower cables are divided by four cable elements with nodes in between. In the animator we see here the deformation of the nodes, and in WinGraph we can look to the cable sagging. The long cable has a sagging that we now see in WinGraph, and the small cables we only see the sagging of the segments. But if we want, we can add this view in WinGraph, so we can make a plot of the cable sagging on the deformed structure, and then we really see the correct effect. If we load our cable inside, like here, we of course must have inner nodes. And if we are interested in the dynamics inside the cable, of course we also have to divide the cable so that we get masses inside the cable. There's a nice example, cabledynamics.dat. If we calculate eigenfrequencies on a cable, in the example cabledynamics.dat in the geometric nonlinear folder, we can start with a primary load case. Here we have the system straight. The primary load case is a cable with deformation, and if we make eigenfrequencies on this primary load case, we can really get the first eigenfrequency swinging in this horizontal direction in the deformed shape. In the time step analysis, we can use cables as well, but we have to divide the cables. Here we see a deformation on the top, and then we see the wave going down. This example shows a cable that is cut in the analysis. One cable is cut, and we see the nonlinear effect of this. Now, coming to the form finding. In form finding, we must really play with the cables. I have here a very simple example that you can also access in the additional examples of the AVI files. We have three mast and three cables, group 1, 2, 3. In the center, we have defined a mass that will produce a loading at the inner node. And keep in mind, an inner cable sagging acts only if we have an inner load on the cable element, usually dead load. In a first analysis, we just activate the dead load and make an analysis TH3. We see here the deformation going down a little bit, and the cables get, of course, a normal force and an inner cable sagging. Now we play with the pre-stress. We can define that the cables have no stiffness, factor of stiffness is nearly zero, and we want a given pre-stress of 5 kN. Now we see the result is that the deformation goes to the correct point of equilibrium where all cables have 5 kN, and now the angles between the three cables are really 120 degrees, which is the correct position for equal cable forces. So the cables now behave like a rubber gum. They are very, very weak, and also if they get a deformation, the 5 kN remain in the cable, like in a rubber gum. In the next example, we just make only 1.5 kN. We see the deflection is higher. Cable force is of course lower. If you look to the top example, to this point, in the next example, we have an additional deformation because now the pre-stress is only 0.7 kN. In the next example, we play again with the pre-stress. Group 1 and 2, that are the left cables, are only defined with 0.7 kN and the right one with 1.2. Now we see this cable pulls to the right and we get really a big deformation in our system, but also an equilibrium in space with these given forces. In the next example, we tell the program group number 1 is not a rubber cable but has a fixed stiffness of 1. That means that the length of the cable cannot change and it will rotate to this position. The other cables are rubber cables and can change the length. That means that our system will rotate around this axis and we get this position in the result. If we define that group number 1 and 2 are fixed cables, then these two cables are fixed and the node must go down to this position, so the rotation will rotate around this axis. And group number 3, a rubber cable, we can define a pre-stress, and of course this pre-stress will remain in the system. The other cables can change the force now. There is also a nice example in the membranes folder, cablefishnet.dat, where we have a starting system, and if we just activate the dead load, we get this deformed shape. We can combine the cables, including incremental launching. We see here a cable state bridge that in the erection has an incremental launching and a help cable helping the bridge to come to the other side, and also in the beginning a help pylon with help cables to come over the river. This was an overview over cable structures, theoretical background, and thank you for your attention.